Let's solve one previous question of relation. This question was asked in GATE CS 2021 set 1 question number 43. A relation R is said to be circular if A is related to B and B is related to C. Together implies C is related to A. Which of the following option is or are correct, and 4 options are given. If you will see in every option it is asking about equivalence relation. What is equivalence relation? A relation is equivalence if it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. What is reflexive? If A is related to A, then it is reflexive. What is symmetric? If A is related to B and B is related to A, then it is symmetric. What is transitive? If A is related to B and B is related to C, implies A is related to C. So one relation is equivalence if it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. And here another property given, that is circular. What is circular? If A is related to B, B is related to C, then C must be related to A. So that is circular. Now let's check the option A. If a relation S is reflexive and symmetric, then S is equivalence relation. This is false. For equivalence, it should be reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Here it's written just reflexive and symmetric, hence it is false. Next option B, if a relation S is circular and symmetric, then S is an equivalence relation. So it's given it is circular and symmetric. For equivalence, it should be reflexive, symmetric, transitive. But it's only circular and symmetric. Let's try to derive further. It can be reflexive and transitive from circular and symmetric. So we have three elements, let A, B, C. So A is related to B, B is related to C, C is related to A. That is circular. And it is symmetric. Symmetric means B can be related to A, C can be related to B, and A can be related to C. So A is related to B, B is related to C, and A is related to C means it is transitive. So from circular and symmetric, we found a relation can be transitive. But there are no way that we can prove it is reflexive. So the relation is symmetric and transitive but not reflexive. As it is not reflexive, hence it is not equivalence relation. Next option C, if a relation S is reflexive and circular, then S is an equivalence relation. It is reflexive means A is related to A, and circular means A is related to B, B is related to C, means C is related to A. This is reflexive and circular. For equivalence, it should be reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So the relation is reflexive and circular. Let's try to derive. It is symmetric and transitive. So reflexive means, suppose we have three elements. So A can be related to A, B can be related to B, and C can be related to C. Suppose we'll take AA and AB from circular. Okay? Means A is related to A, A is related to B, then B can be related to A according to circular property. So from these two, B can be related to A. AB is present, BA can be present, means it is symmetric. So you can also take BB, BC. From BB, BC, CB can be present. BC is present, CB can be present, hence it is symmetric. Now check for transitive. A, B, B, C are related means C, A is related. It is symmetric means A, C can also be related. So A, B, B, C, A, C means it is transitive. Hence we found this relation S can be reflexive, symmetric and transitive. From reflexive and circular we can derive that this relation is symmetric and transitive. Hence it is equivalence relation. Next option D, if a relation S is transitive and circular, then S is an equivalence relation. Transitive means A related to B, B related to C means A related to C, Circular means A related to B, B related to C, C related to A. So here A is related to C, here C is related to A, means it is symmetric. So from transitive circular we can derive it is symmetric. But there are no way we can prove this is reflexive, hence it is not equivalence relation. So we found option A, option B and option D are not equivalence relation, while option C is equivalence relation. Answer is option C. If a relation S is reflexive and circular, then S is an equivalence relation. Reflexive, circular means that can be symmetric, also transitive. I already discussed equivalence relation, just go through the lecture, and if this lecture is helpful for you, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.